Good afternoon, YouTubers. Welcome to the seaside. I'm going to go and take you up and try and hopefully get a view underwater what's underneath the sea. I'm really thirsty because I need a drink now. I'll go and get one in a second. So we're going to go right up to the end of the cove up here. And past all the plastic rubbish and the big boulders, I'm going to go and see if we can get a view under the water. Hopefully at some little fishes or something. Probably won't happen, but you know what they say, it's worth a try, isn't it, eh? Here we go then. Whoa! This is the deserted part of the beach up here. It's very rocky. This seems to be the little bit of the beach where no one goes. Apart from, obviously, you get all the occasional crap and rubbish which people are too lazy to take home with them. Cans of Stella, we've got belts. Cans of Strongbow, there's belts, there's metal cans, nice and plates, shoes. All the human crap that people leave behind that can't be bothered to take home with them. If I show you just behind me, you'll see surrounded by a massive cliff, which I wouldn't recommend climbing up, to be fair with you. Also down here is the stuff left behind by fishing boats. So we've got bits of rope and things, and bits of general fishing rubbish and nets. Someone's nicely left a rug down there that can't be bothered to take home with them. And we're going underneath the cliff now, so we're going into darkness. There's a metal pulley wheel for a generator. And, oh, I always check the water line. You can see when the tide comes in that this is wet, which means when the tide comes in, if I'm stood here, this is going to be under the water, and I don't want to get trapped and have to ring the RNI because I'm stuck on the edge of this cliff for the water coming in, do I? That'd be a really bad idea. There's a piece of, down here looks a piece of industrial, looks like sheet metal. Looks like what remains off a shipping container of some sort. That's nice. But you can see how much power the water's got. If you look behind me, this is where, when the tide comes in, that's where the water level's going to be, right there. So it's going to come up about a good 8 to 10 foot. And then everywhere you go in the Peak District and Cumbria and everywhere, you find this. People can't be asked to pick up after themselves. Plastic bottle. Takes 1,000 years to biodegrade. But it's okay, because people just chuck them and leave them on the beach because they think that's acceptable, which is a sad. Oh, you can see how far up the water's getting now, can't you? Right. Along here, there's got to be a little bit where the water level don't drop so that I can try and get some footage underwater. Whoa! It's just nice to be by the sea, isn't it? Okay. Right, there's a big rock here. This is good. This is good. Oh, no! But you can't honestly expect me to go over there, can you? Well, there's more industrial rubbish down here. GoPro fans, there's more plastic bottles that people have left. There's rubber industrial piping, that's at the bottom of the sea, that carries fibre optic cable. Which probably goes out to the oil rigs or the fans in the corner. Fans, you know what I mean, wind stations. You never know what's over here unless you look, do you? Real quick look there. I'm not going to spend too long over here because if the sea level rises, I want to be gone out of here. No, there's just loads more human rubbish. Loads more crap that people can't be bothered to take home with them. Sorry if it sounds like I'm going on, it's just not very nice, is it? You know what I mean? There's another Foster's can here that someone just cannot be bothered to take home with them. You know what I mean? That's it really. Not a lot. Oh, there's more plastic rubbish behind me there. That's nice of them, isn't it? There's more industrial hosing. you'll see it's got metal around it like this, look. And in the metal, that metal there, that's where the cable normally goes. It carries electric signals to obviously offshore wind farms. And when the divers are done with it, or whatever it is they're doing with it, they just chuck it in the sea like a piece of rubbish. And then it washes up on here for your kids to find. It's industrial rubbish. You can't blame that on anyone rather than people that work out into the middle of the sea. Right, now I've finished talking crap to you and nonsense, let's try and see if we can get in a position where we can get you. Well, there we go. Now this is more like it, look. This is more like it. I am stood on double rock with the water swelling around me, look. Now that is more like it. Look down here, look. That's more like it. That is beautiful, eh? Beautiful. Right, so we see if we can do an underwater shot without hopefully losing my GoPro. Here we go. I've no idea if that works or not because I can't check till I get home. But I just did an underwater shot, okay? As I'm stood here on top of this big ginormous rock trapped by the beautiful seaside, which is all around me. Okay, here we go again. Underwater shot.